Guys, we're really excited to have you here, seeing Repo theatrically. Who's actually seen Repo before? Raise your hands. Excellent. How many of you guys have heard the soundtrack if you haven't seen the movie? Okay, some of you guys. So we're going to start off, we do this every night, just to really gauge the reaction if you guys know the music. So, Terrance, if I were to ask you a question, I hope maybe the audience would know the answer to it. Zitrate comes in a little glass vial.
A little glass vial?
All right, good. Some of your fans. We want to ask one favor, and I always ask this for every audience. Guys, I want you to have fun with this movie. If you like it, cheer. If you hate it, boo. Just don't be silent. Some of you guys know the music. Sing along. This is not a movie where you guys need to be silent in.
Drug market, submarket. Sometimes I wonder why I ever got in. Blood market, love market. Sometimes I wonder why they need me at all. Zitrate comes in a little glass vial.
A little glass vial?
A little glass vial.
And the little glass vial goes into the gun like a battery. And the Zitrate gun goes somewhere against your anatomy. And when the gun goes off, it sparks and you're ready for surgery. Surgery.
Grave robber, sometimes I wonder why I even bother. Grave robber, grave robber, sometimes I wonder why I need you at all.
And Amber Sweet is addicted to the knife.
Addicted to the knife?
Addicted to the knife.
And addicted to the knife, she needs a little help with the agony. And a little help comes in a little glass vial and a gun pressed against her anatomy. And when the gun goes off, Miss Sweet is ready for a surgery.
Thank you so much for checking the movie out and staying. I know you can buy it on DVD right now. Who has a DVD? Anyone buy the DVD yet? Oh, you see that? You see that back there, Luke? Nice. Here we go. Well, guys, the first thing I'd encourage all of you to do, if you like the movie, tell your friends about it. You know, we're a small movie. We're trying to get the word out there, kind of underground through grassroots efforts. So if you liked it, please tell your friend. If you didn't like it, fuck it. Tell your friends, too.
We worked with a studio called Yowza Animation.
Right.
And yes. They did all the coloring and the sort of compositing of the images. All the illustrations are hand-done. I did all the line art. I was looking at, I don't know if there's any graphic novel or comic book fans in the house. I'm guessing there is.
Yes!
You know Tim Sale's The Long Halloween?
Yes.
I like the simplicity of it, the fact that it looked sort of retro. There was no modern, like, Photoshop airbrush techniques.
Precisely.
I hate that.
You could see
and everything is, like, very graphic, black, stark contrast, and limited color palettes.
Well, I'll say this about Rocky Horror. Rocky Horror is one of my favorite movies. I think that we'll be lying if we both say we weren't inspired to some respect by Rocky Horror. But this is not Rocky Horror, nor could we ever be Rocky Horror. Rocky Horror is its own thing. It's its own movie. I think the comparisons are coming because of the community. And what I mean by that is if you go to Rocky Horror Picture Show, and it shows, I think it's in 300 cities in the States every weekend, at midnight, you get sold out crowds, people yelling and screaming and throwing props and, you know, being belligerent. And I think that's what Repo is. It's people that are, it's a community. It's people that, you know, it's kind of crazy. We have a website. And I hope some of you guys are on it, repo-opera.com. Anyone here that's on the website, raise your hand. I would like to know. Okay, so we have some people here that's on it. It's turned into like a real community. And what I mean by that is not only are friends meeting, we're getting seriously people hooking up on the website. I did three of basically the same movie. Saw 2, 3, and 4. While they're great, and I had an amazing time doing them, they're all the same movie. They're in an underground dungeon. There's a bathroom in it somewhere. There's going to be a twist. There's going to be a twist at the very end. Do you guys want to know the twist of Saw 6? Because I'll tell you, because they're filming it right now. No.
No. So you know, it was cool to do something completely different. I think anyone here that has a routine in their life, they want to break that routine. If you wake up every morning and you go to the same job and you come home and you have sex with the same woman and you eat the same dinner every night, you want to do something different.
Paris did do her own stuff. Everyone did. And I think, you know, something it's kind of interesting about making a movie like this is we recorded the music months, I think 2 months before we ever went to set. And what that means is every actor has to commit to the role they're playing before they saw what they were wearing, knew what the sets looked like. So, for example, Shiloh, Alexa Vega, or Paris Hilton, or Sarah Brightman came in to a studio and sang their parts and didn't know what the hell the sets were going to look like, what their costumes were going to look like, or what the movie was going to be.
Oh, Shiloh, that was close. Take your medicine.
And so they had to commit to their characters then. And then 2 months after the fact, we went to a set, they saw their costumes, they saw the sets, and they had to lip sync back to their own lyrics that they sang. And it's crazy. It's basically making your part in the dark.